Now today I'm going to be working on a background with a bald eagle, and I want this background to blend out to the white of the paper. But this is going to be quite an impact against the white head of a bird. Let's give it a try, shall we? And let's get them brushes wet. Hi, my name is Paul Hopkinson, and I'm a wildlife artist, and I teach online through my art courses on my website. And if you fancy having a go at painting a robin in watercolour for a free video lesson, have a look at the link in the description down below, join as a free member and give it a try. Now my aim with this painting is to create a background that blends out to the white of the paper, so colourful on the inside and gradually gets lighter towards the edge of the sheet of paper. But for this I'm going to be working with two brushes. This one's a synthetic size 18 and it tends to hold the water really well, and it's got a good spring back rate as well, which is really nice. And this is a mop brush which I want to use for just applying the main water to begin with. And that's made out of squirrel hair, but there are synthetic versions as well. Now when I apply the water, I want to make sure that it's going to soak into the paper. And I want to make sure it's going to stay wet enough and luff along enough while I add that background on. So I need to wet it probably two, maybe three times and allow each layer of water to soak into that paper. You can see how it cockles actually, you know, when it starts to soak in and you get that kind of warp and the way it undulates on the paper surface. But because I'm using a block pad, this should dry nice and flat when it's done. Now if you never use a block pad, all it simply is a pad of paper with loads of sheets all kind of glued all the way around the edge, bar one small gap right at the very top. And that allows you, when the painting's done and dry, to slide a little bit of a palette knife all the way around and take off that one sheet of paper. So using my size 18, I'm just applying a little bit of burnt sienna, as you can see, but I'm thinking about the overall curve of this, the overall shape. Remember, I've wetted the entire sheet of paper, apart from obviously the bird. But I don't want to put the colour through all that wet area. I just want to make sure I've got the colour more like a gentle arc, okay? So that's what I'm thinking about. Just so you can't see when it blends out, you can't see where one colour starts and the other colour sort of finishes, you know? And that's what my aim with this one. Now, I'm also looking at this bird, and because it's obviously a bald eagle, we've got to think about the white of the head. Now, because it's white, I need the background to be quite dark. Otherwise, it's not going to stand out, is it? However, the shoulder areas, a little bit lower down, are quite dark on this bird. So I've got to think about having the lower areas lighter than the top areas. So probably the first two-thirds of the painting down needs to be fairly dark and gradually get lighter as it gets towards the bottom. Also, don't forget to click on that subscribe button down below, and don't forget that bell icon as well, just so you'll never miss one of my YouTube videos. So again, I'm going to re-wet certain areas as well. And one thing that I don't want to happen is for it to start to dry, and then you get all these kind of cauliflower marks, they call them, don't they? Around the paint itself. It can be quite effective, actually. But in this case, I just want a nice, gentle, mottled background. So I'll have a look at that later on and see how well it dries. But as you can see, it can lift off a little bit of paint. So I'm going to try and control the flow of this water. That's one of the things, isn't it, with watercolour? It's trying to control the flow of it. Trying to control it and trying to work out where it's going to go. But you're in charge, you can control it if you take your time with it. Even with a background that's gradually drying as you're working on it, you can still take time to control the flow of water. And that all depends on how much water you've got within your paint. And as you can see, lifting off any runs that you get, you need to do that before it runs off the bottom of the sheet, because my board's on the slight angle here. Now I'm going to add some lamp black. Now lamp black is one of those colours which you wouldn't normally, or I certainly wouldn't normally, use on its own. However, using it within a wet background, so I'm actually mixing this with the colours on there. So therefore, that's enriching that black. It's not going to be a flat looking black, as it would be if you used it on its own. So if you're going to use black within a painting, I would suggest you mix a colour with it, like a cool colour like a blue, or a warm colour like a red, you know, alizarin crimson or probably French ultramarine or something like that. Just kind of change the properties of it, just kind of enrich it that little bit more. So I'm going to re-wet and just make sure that it's wet enough to kind of carry on getting this layer on the background. But remember, I don't want to go too dark for the low areas. That's why I'm kind of easing off the colour down there as well. So these are my thought processes while I'm working on this. As with every background, even though you don't want to rush it, you don't want it to start to dry on you. So you don't want to take too long doing it. Because even though you've wetted it 2, 3, 4, 10 times, whatever it might be, and allowed every layer to soak into the paper, as I said earlier on, you still got to remember it's still going to dry on you, isn't it? Which it will. So to be able to control the flow of the paint, to be able to control the flow of the water, you've got to give yourself more of like a time limit, probably 10 minutes or something like that, to work on a mottled kind of faded background. So watch out for that paper drying all the time. What I tend to think about is that when I'm working on a paint on the background, I think, well, where did I wet first? Because that's the area, when you think about it, that will start to dry first as well. So think about it on those terms when you're working on a background or a large area, putting lots and lots of washes on. So I'm going to continue adding this black in there, and I want to darken just the inner areas now of all this section, so it gradually goes lighter as it goes out towards the paper. So that's why I'm going really dark around the head. Remember, the head has got loads and loads of white feathers on it, on a bald eagle, which it has, as we all know. But I just want to very lightly blend this as well. So using my mop brush, just go around the edge every now and then and just kind of mix in some of them colours together. If I'm not quite happy with the way it's kind of floating on the surface, whilst it's still nice and wet, then you can control that. However, if you start to see the shine go off the paper, that's when you want to think about, maybe I need to leave it now. This is nice and dry. And now it's nice and dry. You can see that it's faded a little bit. It's going to lighten as it dries, which is natural with watercolors anyway. So removing all that masking fluid reveals all the fine lines I've got for the feathers as well. Quite effective just on its own, isn't it? Now I've got the painting on. You can see I'm working with a watercolor white. And look at the contrast I've got. It's not a really dark background, is it? It looked like it when I was adding the paint on, when it's nice and wet. But because it's dried that little bit lighter, you can see that the background itself is more of a mid-tone, isn't it? But it's dark enough, isn't it? It's dark enough to allow the white of the head for all these lovely feathers to stand out against that background. So you can see the overall effect they've got with this and the way that the background blends out to the white of the paper. You can see the way that I've kind of spread the paint around for that background and how well it blends out. Now, would you like to learn how to paint birds' feathers? Have a look at the video to the right and I'll see you there.